It's a great, great thing here to see so many fans, spectators, supporters, parents. Really thank you for taking time out of your weekend and helping us do this not so little celebration. As you know, a lot of work goes into this night. A lot of blood, sweat, and tears. And I think I saw a few tears in the last couple of days. I did see a lot of joy. And we're going to be here to maybe hear some stories and celebrate in those experiences. We do want to get the evening started with a few words from our CEO at USA Luge, Jim Leahy.
Thank you, Sandy. You know, as the new CEO, I've been on for almost 3 months now, and I don't know whether I have anything to do with what's going on here today. But all seriousness, what I'd like to do is I want to thank you all for coming. On behalf of myself and our executive board, John Fee is president, Jim Murphy is here, Catherine Turdeman is here. We want to thank you all for being here tonight. I also want to thank a couple of our partners. The USOC has been a great partner with us and significantly over the last 3 months, a big supporter of ours. Our foundation has been a major supporter of ours, came up with the necessary funds that we needed to make sure that we put the best team together and we're ready to go to Sochi. You know, I've come to see that this is a family. And I think that when we take a look at what Mark has done, what Miro has done, to get us to this point, it's just, in my mind, it's a fantastic day for us. We have a staff that I think that you should know that works extremely hard to make sure that we put these things together. Gordy Shear has been here, Dimitri's been here, Beverly in our office has been here. Amy made sure that the jackets for our athletes came here on time. It's just a great group to be involved with. I also want to thank Colin Hilton and his folks here at the track. They've done a phenomenal job all week, and without their help, we couldn't have done this. I'd be remiss to not recognize Sven Romstedt. Also has been a major supporter of mine since the day I walked in, and he's been a great adversary. Sven, I thank you. So to move this along, I want to thank you all, and I tell you what, this group of athletes is ready to compete to win medals at Sochi. If you take this group, put into this, and I tell you what, tonight the fruits paid off. So Sandy, I'm going to pass it back. Thank you all.
Thank you, Jim. Okay. The director of sponsorships and marketing is Gordy Shear, 1998 Olympic silver medalist, as you all know. Gordy would like to thank some supporters that we have had along the way here on this journey. Gordy.
Thank you, Sandy. Thanks, Jim. And the sound man in me is going to turn it. Can you guys still hear out there okay?
Oh, yeah.
Sorry. All right. Just to reiterate everything that's been said, we're very proud and very thankful of everything that everyone in this room has done, whether it be friends, family, sponsors, officials, volunteers, members of the press. We really appreciate everything that everybody's done for us. With that in mind, I do have my thank you list. So, I want to thank Norton, Saint-Gobain, Team Worldwide, World Financial Group, the Army National Guard, the Army World Class Athlete Program, our friends from the San Diego Low Speed Wind Tunnel, Clarkson University, Jesse and Holly Arndt for the beautiful backdrop behind me, Shades of Pale Brewing for the wonderful beer, the NBC Sports Network for the show which will air from 9 to 11 a.m. Eastern Time, our friends from USANA, and Westworld Media, Brett West, for our new website. I don't know if you've had a chance to check it out. It's very wonderful. And of course, the live streaming, which everyone's getting to see at home, and those who are not in attendance. Also, we want to thank our sponsors watching at home. That includes Dow Chemical, Avalanche Skiwear, CWX, Black Diamond Technologies, Fast Radios, Ludus Tours, Maisley Enterprise, Pilot Chemical, SureTech Brands, Traveler's Choice, U-Haul, and Vulcan GMS. And a special thanks to the FIL and the Utah Olympic Park. So I am going to turn it back over to Sandy, I believe.
Yep.
Sandy? Thank you, everybody. Really appreciate you being here.
Thank you very much, Gordy. And I should mention, I was fortunate and proud to be there in 1998 when this man won his silver medal with Chris Thorpe. And we have another medalist from back in those days in 98 when the team won their first two, and then of course repeated with two more 4 years later right here, of all places. So now we'd like to bring Jim Leahy back because we have a very, very important announcement as we work our way toward announcing the 10 nominees to the Sochi Olympic team. Jim has an announcement, and we'd like to bring on a special guest. Jim, once again.
Again, things like this don't happen without the support of our great sponsors. What we'd like to do tonight is I'd like to bring Brad Johnson up from Norton. In a room somewhere.
Yeah, right here.
Oh, there we go. Brad and his company have just committed that they're going to work with USA Luge for the next 4 years, not only take us to Sochi, but to Korea.
Thanks, Jim. It really is a pleasure to be here and be the representative of all the employees and customers of Norton Company and really be part of a great team. It was a great weekend. We had a large number of employees here that thoroughly enjoyed all the action, and really to see the dedication and the teamwork from Team USA Luge with the great performances and the results today. So our sponsorship goes back a few years, but we've been involved with USA Luge for over 30 years, just starting by providing them the sandpaper and abrasives to fix their equipment, all the way up to more recently becoming the primary sponsor, and also using our research scientists to help them with the recipes for the steels that they use on their flex. So it's a great pleasure for me to be here, represent the company, represent our employees, and be part of this great team, and wish everybody well in Sochi.
One more time, Brad Johnson and his company.
Thank you, Brad, and thank you, Jim. So now we get to the 10 members, the 10 nominees to the Sochi Winter Olympic team, the 10 that we will take to that track at the Sankey Sliding Center in Hard. We have two doubles, as you know, that will compete in the Sochi Games. And our next team qualified yesterday in a special race off. It was tight right throughout the fall, right to the very end. So I guess it was only fitting that it would happen that way. And again, we bring out together from Woodinville, Washington, outside of Seattle, Christian Nickham, and from Berwick, PA, Jason Turnaman. Just a little story here, especially about Christian. Yesterday, you know, there was the race-off against Jay Kearns and Andrew Shirk, and it was a great battle all the way down for that second Olympic berth. And after the first heat, Christian and Jason had an 800th of a second lead. You know, 800th of a second, you know, it's not really a whole lot. But, you know, in luge, there's a lot of time to kill between runs. You know, you can talk yourself in and out of a whole lot of things in those couple of hours. But Christian got a text message, or video actually, from his wife, because yesterday his one-year-old daughter took her first steps. That kind of has a way of calming you down, putting it all in perspective, and then the team took their second run and nailed down that second Olympic berth. Okay, so now we go on to the ladies' single. Not only this lady I'm going to introduce, but Marianne Baribault is also a junior world champion for La Cañada. So La Cañada is the junior world luge championship capital of this country. So with that, Kate Hansen. Our next athlete on the women's side has been the rock of this team for a few years. She'll go to her third Olympics, won the 2009 World Championship. From Remsen, New York, the central New York part of the state, Erin Hamlin. And rounding out the women's team and rounding out the 10 athletes that we will take, from Glen Rock, Pennsylvania, going to her first games, Summer Richard. Now, we don't know if these guys can fight their way through the crowd because they're not as sprightly as they used to be. But we want to acknowledge certainly the coaching staff, the sport program director, and two-time Olympic medal winner, Mark Grimmett. The head coach of USA Luge is Meryl Zions. Assistant coaches are Bill Tavares and Clint Gatger. And our trainer, Matt Oakes. And so I think we're going to have a few questions here momentarily from the press. So we'll just start randomly with some questions that typically when we do press conferences, I throw the first, you know, softballs out there and kind of warms them up. So now I want to start with Preston because this is, you know, like home turf for Preston. And we talked a little earlier. Is it working?
Yeah.
It's not working. Hang on a second. We can't go to commercial, can we, Brandon?
Well, we can just do a dance.
Just get up on the table. Just, yeah.
I've got a loud voice, so.
We may have to go with that.
It's up. Preston, it should be up.
Hello?
Okay. Yeah,
it's working.
Preston, you qualified on your home track yesterday. You got a silver medal in the relay today. Must be something about the state, huh?
Yeah, this is awesome. I mean, when Matt and I saw that this
was going to be the last World Cup before the Olympic team was announced. We saw that on the schedule, and we were pretty psyched because we knew that we could come here and do well. Really glad we could get done here.
Okay, thanks, Preston. Why don't you hand the mic over to Chris, because this man has been on fuego here in the last few weeks. Actually, you know, going back toward the middle of last season, things have really rounded into form. Chris, talk about being part of this group, and also for a minute or so, if you can, talk about what's been happening with you recently here.
I don't even know that. But yeah, I am at this table with nine others that, you know, we all share so much passion for this sport. We all have amazing potential. And of course, it's always amazing to come to a home track and perform really well. As for what's going on with me right now, you can't really place a word on it. You've been trying, or at least I've been trying so hard over the past 4 years to just become better every week, every season. And I think I'm finally peaking at the right time. I have an amazing organization behind me, great coaching staff, and of course, you have to have your teammates that are supporting you. Even though we are racing against each other, I couldn't do without these people here pushing me, allowing me to be the best that I can be.
Great, thanks, Chris. And then we'll go to Aaron. Aaron, around 1999, I think you came through the slider search down there in the Utica, New York area, near your hometown of Remsen. And when you went through the slider search and then got the invitation from U.S. Solutions, they up and you want to get the chance to on ice. What were your thoughts then, and if you can then fast forward now three Olympic teams, did you ever think it could materialize in this way?
Definitely not. I really had no idea what I was getting myself into. I thought it was a cool opportunity. My brother actually tried out the same time I did, and he didn't make it, so it was kind of like a weird little sister thing. He's here somewhere, so sorry, right? But it was really motivating, and it was something completely different, and I think without even really knowing where it would take me, I am glad that I did it, and it's been quite a ride. It's been 13 years of this, and it's been awesome, and I'm excited to, go back to the games.
Great, thank you very much. Now, we have Beanie here that have been so kind as to put our event on their schedule. If there are questions here from Press Row, please step forward and fire away.
Preston, talk about your teammate.
What else can I say? He's a special guy. No, Matt and I have known each other for a long time, 10 plus years. And actually when Matt and I first started traveling together, we were competing, we were on different doubles teams. And we've grown up with each other, really. I mean, since we were probably 13, 14 years old, we started traveling internationally for months on end. And he's definitely one of my best friends, along with everybody on the team. Like one big family, you kind of have to be when you're traveling together for 6 months at a time, living in a hotel. So, but Matt's great. The biggest thing that I have learned over the years is that Matt is one of the most loyal people that I know, and I know that I can count on him to have my back and to pick me up when I'm down. And if we're having problems on the track or even off the track, I know that I can count on him to be a rock and be solid and keep pushing on. So,
that's funny.
Gonna make me cry. But Matt's great, and I'm super happy to have him as my teammate. And I know that we're gonna keep focused and look forward to Sochi and looking to get a medal, bring it back home. Yeah.
More questions, please. Joe.
Who's the oldest member of the team? All right. So as the oldest member of the team, do you feel any obligation to kind of set a tempo or to set an example? And also, what is it like having a family in Dubuque?
Oh,
Well, oldest member of the team. We all do luge, so I really feel like we're all kids out here, living out a dream of skipping school and going sledding. As far as having a family of my own, that's a real dream come true, for sure. You know, we live the dream of going Olympics and gold medal, and it's awesome, that dream. But having a family is it's a whole nother level. It's a very high peak, which I'm sure everyone has a family.
We'll take some more questions. Or I can keep the thing going myself. Aiden, why don't you grab the mic, please? Today was kind of an interesting day. You were flying to a certain point. Your thoughts about being on an Olympic team and the journey that you've been on?
Well, this is amazing. It's the greatest honor I think any athlete can have bestowed upon them. I'm super happy to be here with all these people that are my best friends and my family. It's just amazing. It's hard to find words to describe it. It was a rough day. It was a roller coaster of emotions. It was the first time I doubted making the Olympic team. And I'm just happy that everything turned out how it did.
Okay. Questions here. Questions. Okay. Tucker, grab the microphone, please. Has it sunk in on your AD? Okay. Now from the press. Joe, go ahead.
Yeah, let's talk to the girls for a minute. So ladies, tell me what it's like to be a little, the smaller group among them, among the athletes here.
Well, we're definitely the minority, but we pack a punch, so everyone's ready. No, we really, they say we're family, we really are. We live together and we've known each other for so long, so I definitely don't think we're lesser the bunch, but nope, just proud of my girls, you know, sticking up for ourselves.
Questions? We'll take one even from the audience if we got something like that. Someone who hasn't spoken yet. Just speak up so we can all hear you. Joe, go ahead,
all right,
man.
Yeah, okay. All right, for all of you then, who had the most crazy run? Like something that just didn't go right, you weren't expecting it. Of the entire week.
I crashed, so I think I did.
Say that again.
Well, I crashed, so I think I win that round, unfortunately. It was probably the best run I had had all week. I was really looking forward to this race. I had great training, I loved the track. And like I said, everything was going very well. And I just got lazy and got distracted by all the cowbells and people screaming.
You're gonna have to get used to that.
Yeah, and then just let my sled get too much height on the end of 12, crossed me early to 13, and it's such a quick corner. So I just hit the beginning and had no chance of bringing it back together, just dumped it. And that was the first time I ever doubted making the team.
Did anybody have the ideal run, the run that you think is the best you've had to this point?
I honestly have to say today for the team competition that I had the exact run that I pictured having. Before we go down, we always do visualizations. We call them mind runs. But you're really trying to pick exactly what you're going to do and envision having a perfect run. And today in the team competition, I felt that I did just that. So that was extremely exciting.
Yeah.
most excited about with Soshi for each of you? Is it food? Is it the competition? You know, like besides the competition, I mean, tell me something else that you're excited about going to Soshi for.
Definitely not the food.
I'm really excited to go see other Team USA athletes competing. I think that's going to be a really cool part of the Olympics for me. I heard we can get into most of the outdoor sporting events for free, so I'm pumped for that. And it's just going to be great to cheer on Team USA while we're there.
I'd have to say that in Sochi, just having so many countries beyond luge, there's a lot of countries that aren't represented in luge, and they'll be all there competing in Sochi. There's so many cultures coming together, so many different people. And you know, it's all centralized in one place, and I think that's really special. And something I took away from Vancouver, and I'm looking forward to in Sochi.
Awesome.
Go ahead, Joe. You got the floor.
Yeah, why not? So, which of you went around this estimate? How many people have been at the track before in Sochi?
Everybody.
Has anybody got some comments on the track?
Awesome. Matt, why don't you take that one, please?
The track, we'll go with Mike.
Oh, this isn't going to work anymore.
All right, hold on.
Oh, we have gremlins in the room here.
I can speak loud too.
No power.
We had this happen in Sochi.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that's good.
For a week. Please test try again.
Test one, two, check. No. Nothing here.
Is there electrician? Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
That's an electrician.
Did we pay the bill? Matt, how are your vocal cords answering that question?
Yeah. The track in Sochi is pretty unique compared to other tracks. It's got a lot of long sweeping curves, and actually, since the track in Vancouver was so fast, I think they estimated the speeds, the top speeds in Sochi, to be even faster than that of Vancouver. And after the tragedy that was in Vancouver, they decided that they needed to put in a couple of uphill sections in the track, which is quite abnormal for a regular luge course. So those particular uphill sections are really tricky. It makes for weird pressures in the corners that we have to navigate through while we're going down. So that that those specific corners are highly unusual. Those specific corners are highly unusual for luge in general.
Okay, so we're back on the air.
How excited is Christmas this year for you guys? This must be like the best Christmas gift ever.
Now that I have a microphone, I'm going to speak to you. I'm super excited to go home for Christmas. This has been an extremely long half for all of us. This has been the longest first half that we've had traveling, I think, ever, or in years. A lot of members of the team went to Lillehammer, Norway, September 28th of this year. So we've pretty much been on the road since then. And for those of us that are not from Utah, you know, it'll be really nice to get back to our home ground, even if it's only for 10 days. But it'll be really nice to get back.
Okay, we do have audience participation time here now, so please ask a question.
Hi, guys. So from here on in, of course, every one of you are now in Sochi. As a team, as a whole, what's your guys' focus and mind frame from here on out until Sochi competition?
We're going to let Summer take a shot at that question. Go ahead, please.
I guess for me, I wasn't really prepared to make it this far, and it's amazing that I did. And so now I just want to keep trying to improve and train hard to try to be peaking during the Olympics.
Thank you for asking the question. Other questions on the media? And we can maybe take another question from from the audience here, if anyone wants to raise their hand or yell it forward, of anyone in particular? Oh, we just want to kind of get the party started, don't we? Yeah, something like that. Okay, what we're going to do, at a certain point here in the next couple minutes, we're just going to allow the media and the athletes to informally get together. But first, we have a special presentation of the team jackets. And Brad Johnson from Norton, and Jim Leahy, USA Luge CEO, will distribute the team jackets.
Put them on!
For everybody. Hold up that red, white, and blue. Crunch together so we can take a nice.
That's great looking.
Don, how good is that?
Thank you.
maybe. Of course, you'll get a few more runs when you're there. What do you think of it? Does it suit you?
Yeah, we've actually had quite a few runs on that track. I've probably had more runs on that track than I've had here. So I'm very comfortable on it. I like the track. I like the sliding style. So I'm excited to slide it
here. Tucker West, 18 years old, the youngest male Olympic blues team member. Congratulations. Okay. All right, we're going to try to get a few more folks over here. We're going to get Jason Tournament on next. Jason will live on USANews.org. Yeah, right here on Westworld Media.
Yeah, it's out there in the internet world.
So you've had a little chance here to let it sink in. Sunk in.
Absolutely not. This is something I've been trying to find in a long time. You know, it's finally happened for me.
You know, Christian had some physical problems in the last couple of years. He's battled through back surgery, the Achilles. You know, you probably spent more time away from him than it seems like than you did with him. But you stuck with him. You're sliding, you're home, you're testing equipment. How do you stick with it mentally?
Mentally, it was very tiring. I've always had the faith that Christian and I can start fast together and move together. And it's easy for me because we're doing the classic and I'm with Duncan. I'm testing the new Dow stuff and working with them. It keeps me extremely motivated. Those guys, they know exactly what to say, keep me fired up. They know exactly what to give me and say, test this out. Things worked out really well. I'm glad that what we did last year is helping the team out right now. It's incredible. And hopefully, you know, there's some more stuff going on in the future. And things are going on, sky's the limit.
I know you were crazy about the races, especially in the first 3 or 4 weeks of the World Cup season. It was really a struggle, and I believe you guys have more and better in you. But yesterday, winning the race off against Jake and Andrew, did you sense something in those runs that maybe you can latch on to?
You know, first off, I got to give a shout out to those guys. Jake and Andrew, they put us through a hell of a lot yesterday. They put down 2 solid runs and really made us perform our best. The first run, they beat us in the start, which for me was kind of disappointing. It's the first time all year they beat us in the start. And for me, that's my point of pride because that's my job. So, you know, I gotta give them a shout out. We had our first race where we had 2 new sets of runs, and they both felt great. Time just like that. It's a small set of issue we have in this first couple of races, and as soon as we get that thing set up right, I feel good here so far.
All right, Jason Tournament, the pride of Burwood, Pennsylvania.
Woo, go Dawgs!
Thanks, Jason. Yeah, enjoy the rest of the night now. Okay. Well, we're going to look around now on USANews.org and on Westworld Media for some other folks. Right there. Okay, let's see here. Summer, why don't you come over here? We're live on USANews.org tonight. Okay? Right here on Westworld Media. Is it surreal or is this kind of like a routine for Summer's what you're here seeing?
No, it's not a routine.
I must see if you're awake. Yesterday in the first run. trying hard all the way down the track. I think the cross side is going to be the potential here for some of the people to see the same way.
Training for the team, I'm trying to finish. So, but in the race, I made it through twice really well. So I was hoping that training, I was 50% going through that. So I was hoping, ooh, I could just get 2 runs from there, then decent no skids, I have a chance. And I touched the wall, but no skids, slugging straight. I'm super pumped. The team really went amazing. I had a really fast reaction. And just the run I was
looking for. Chris, as you look back at this evolution towards going back to last winter, we can maybe pinpoint that world championship and wrestlers maybe that started something that's now become really good.
Yeah, I love Whistler. Every time you go to Whistler, I have a personal best result. You know, the Olympics were just for me in 2010. Last year's World Championships, huge for my motivation. Just my self-esteem wall sliding. You know, I wasn't expecting that at all. Same with my second place last week. I wasn't expecting that at all. I knew I could do well. Something was going really well. And then to back it up, that wasn't a fluke, I guess. So I guess, yeah.
Singles race today, that you like being the underdog, you like coming from behind, but you know, a couple of silver medals in singles, you've got a couple of silver medals in the team relay. Because your days are numbered as an underdog?
I'll probably always think of myself as the underdog, just internally it's not to play that way. But even before the race, some people were trying to say, I think it's a top 5 that for me. Two Germans, two Italians, one Czech, two Germans, Italian, Austrian, and my name was in there, whose name is still in the underdog in people's minds.
Today we had a race with no Germans on the podium. And obviously, and we actually had Wolfgang Kendall got his first ever medal. When we go to Sochi, it's kind of a foreign language. Nobody gets any more runs on that track than anybody else other than the Russians, of course. Do you see this as a level playing field where those concrete could be kind of a mixed bag?
You know, the thing is we've had plenty of training in Sochi. Everyone's had at least 3 or 4 weeks of solid, consistent training. What it's going to come down to is the conditions. Right now in February, when I was there 2 years ago, it snowed 4 feet in a week. And then last year there, it was the exact opposite of the warm conditions. So a lot of it was down to conditions. But I think most people understand the track. There's one track in section 4-5, and if you keep feeling it out in the first couple runs, then I really think it's just going to be a good start and be absolutely perfect.
Chris Master, with the silver medal in singles today, silver medal in the relay. Enjoy the rest of the night. You deserve your vacation over the Christmas break. Enjoy.
Thanks, Andy. And thanks for everyone watching at USA News.
Just continue the momentum. 100%. Without the sponsors, we can't do what we do. So,
it's
hard to explain how much of an engineer it is. I'm just saying I can't name all our sponsors. But without them, we can't do a lot. They bring us bring out, they bring a lot of the pressure off of us and allow us to concentrate on sport.
Myself even, that wouldn't get to this thing and we know what's out there, we know what it means. How, and we have such a young group, right from the first time in China, how do you kind of bring them to not get out of focus? This is a lot of distraction in the Olympic angle. Everybody's coming at it from all angles.
Yeah, it's hard to think so, get them focused because like no other race. The atmosphere is totally different. Which what I keep reminding me is everything is just noise. And as soon as they get on the sled and they're on the track, when they're on the track, things are the same. Outside, just deal with the noise. And it'll just filter. Get on the track and push them out of
the nice thing about it is Olympian, and on each side of you tonight we had a couple of Olympic buddies. What can you tell them? Olympic team jacket right now. It looks very cool. I would imagine there might have been a time earlier today where you were wondering if you'd get this impact check.
And then the second I selected Tiger, I realized that I wasn't going to get back on.
I'm hoping to
tell you what I'm going to do. I know, it's horrible. Like I said before, it was the first time I ever doubted that I was going to make it. Because I like to be positive and tell myself everything's going to go
to
plan.
Today
I had to sit and wait and watch and hope that one of my best friends didn't do as well as he wanted to.
That's a pretty brutal part of this story, isn't it?
Really is. Like I've said before, I wish I hated my teammates, but they're my best friends.
And that's a tough one to have to go through. It was quite a journey for you to get to this point, and I think we could probably use the word "culture child" for never giving up. If the folks at home haven't been following maybe that closely, Aiden here in the fall, you were kind of like the odd man out. You were fifth on a 4-man team, but right now you're in the top three going to the Olympics. At a certain point, what did you tell yourself to get yourself to this night tonight or more nights?
I told my parents I was going to make their last Olympic team. Because they would never tell me no. I mean, our family is rich, high demands, but they would never let me not have a shot. They don't tell me to, and I told them, no, I'm not going to let you guys do that. They say, it doesn't matter what class you're going. If you have a shot at it, it's your way.
Maybe you can share with the audience about this luge thing that kind of gets in people's bloodstream. And it's kind of hard to flush it out. The speed thing, or the organization, the camaraderie. What is it for Aiden Kelly about this sport that makes you tick?
You know, you finish last so many times, you want to stick around to see the first result. You're at the bottom for so long, you gotta find out what top feels like, and that's what I'm looking for.
He says people kind of get beat down by this, but not to be negative about it, but I mean, you know, let's face it, it's a tough road to hoe. What is this? Is it a challenge that just keeps wanting more of this?
Yeah, it's a challenge. It's a doubt. It's exhausting. Giving up 2 days for this team. Don't get me wrong, I'm the best 6 years of my life. It's been a third of my life doing this, so half the world. I moved away from my family when I was 15. I missed a ton of school. I didn't see my family in months. It's all right.
Everybody on the scene has a story, and I'll tell you, yours is a great one for being pretty much down and out. And here you are, to take this personal search. You're learning that line from Chris Matthews.
It's more fun than the fall from the top.
Aiden Kelly, thanks a lot. Congratulations for sticking it out. And look at him. Okay. Well, folks. The room has basically been cleared out. I think our time is spent. Fred West on the other side, Westworld Media, his crew back in Connecticut. Thank you guys so much for making this night possible. And you know, we still got a lot of water needs to go under the bridge between now and Sochi. These athletes will rightfully get a Christmas break at home when they really deserve and need to get close to their parents. And then on the 27th of December, it's back on the road, over to Europe, Koenigsee, Germany, a couple more German World Cups, then the finals in Latvia, and then a little camp at the end of January, and on February 1st or so, the trip into Sochi. So once they leave their homes on December 27th, there's no going back home until the games are over. So we keep our fingers crossed, and we thank the folks out there that are watching in tonight and giving their support and keeping their fingers crossed. And we appreciate all the thoughts, the prayers even, that you've sent our way. And as you can see, after the performances here in Park City, this group is out to represent, and they'll represent well. From Park City, Utah, on behalf of the U.S. News Organization, Sandy Calvin-Jordan, thank you very much. And have a great holiday season. Brett, thanks a lot.